God, money and blues. Blues, how do you do?
The cider basically is just juice and fruits that's been fermented naturally.
God, money and blues. Blues, how do you do? Well, I feel alright. Money, how are you? Well, I feel alright.
Today we've travelled from Bakewell, so not too far, about 50 miles or so in the Peak District. Yeah, we've got some events all over the country. Down in London next week for Craft Beer Rising. Go to a lot of the Cameron festivals. It's a great way to people try out beers and shows the laugh as well. Longridge Brewery's been going for 10 years, so since 2005. And yeah, I've grown a lot over the last 10 years. Pretty big player in the craft beer world. Well, it started with two mates essentially, Jim Harrison and Simon Webster. They wanted to build a great brewery in the gardens of Jim's big country house near Bakewell, and we've been brewing since then, and scales are obviously growing a lot more nowadays. The quality of the process that we've got in place. So, we managed to hone the production and make it all quality with a lot of focus on quality control of the ingredients that we use, and people seem to like it. I mean, Jaipur is obviously is our biggest seller. It's the one where it's kind of our first really massive breakthrough beer that we started really 10 years ago. And since then, we've grown and grown. Jaipur has got more and more popular in the UK and around the world as well. The craft beer industry, or the ale industry, is growing and growing with popularity. I mean, craft beer, as we call it, is obviously something that seems to sort of be more and more sort of popular amongst the masses, and we'll see it on the growth here in the future.
10 events like this regularly, so we have ones here in Derby, which is the National Winter Beer Festival. There's also ones locally in Nottingham and Chesterfield, which are really worth going to. Great events. Some days they have free, so you can go, you don't want to pay to get in, you can go just buy yourself a glass, go down, try some different beers, try some different ciders, different wines. So it's not just all about beer, there's other things that are available. So we're in the beer tent at the moment. Later on this evening there'll be some live music. We're going to cheap distribute acts. There's different things to prevent other than just the beer. So, I've personally brewed ale myself. Brewed ale about the last 2 years. Dan's and Dick themselves have been brewing for about 11 years or so. So it's an actual brewery. They've been around for a fairly reasonable amount of time. Derbyshire itself has got over 300 breweries, micro breweries, so it's a pretty good place to come. Nottingham as well, Leicestershire, Midlands is a good club for breweries. The unique thing about Dancing Duck beers is a lot of people enjoy the different names. It's quite silly beers, silly names, but beer tastes themselves are pretty good.
Yeah.
So we've got a lot of different beers, so things like Ale, which are nice and blonde. Lend themselves to people who want to go out for a session beer. Then we've got things like Appearance, which is 3.9%, so you may as well drink those. Most lager drinkers can even try an ale, so you've got some coffee to them, so it's very similar to a lager. Ale is one of our most popular beers, so it's 3.9%. It's a session beer, it's bond. Obviously, with being located in Derby, Ale's a popular slang word for saying hello. People like that. Clubs themselves are quite, kids sort of thing. They're accessible to people.
James. I'm the owner director here at the Brewing Company in Derby. The Brunswick Brewery was set up in 1991. It is now the oldest brewery in Derby. It's our 25th anniversary this year. And it's the oldest one by some way. I think the next one was about 8-9 years after we first set up. It was built as an extension to the pub. The Brunswick Inn was built in 1841, I believe. The oldest purpose-built railwayman's hostelry in the country. Some have said the world, although we doubt that. And it was very much the forefront of the sort of real ale revolution back in the sort of late 80s, early 90s. As far as growth has gone, initially it was built purely just to service the pub, because back in the sort of early 90s there were not a lot of pubs like this around. There were certainly not a lot of breweries, all it did is just brew for itself, and it's pretty much been like that until I took over the brewery about 3 years ago. Since then we've started growing out free trade and going sort of nationwide. Yes, it is widely known as the capital of real ale in the country, and being as England is known as the capital of real ale in the world, therefore Derby by proxy is the capital of real ale in the entire world. The brewing process, in layman's terms, is basically converting starch into sugar and sugar into alcohol. So you're starting off with your raw ingredients, your malt and your hops, you've got water, you add your malted barley to hot water, which through enzymatic reaction breaks down starch into simple sugars, and then from that you boil it up with hops, you boil it up to extract bitterness out of the hops, also to sterilise the product, and then when you've finally done that you cool it down, add some yeast, the yeast then ferments the sugar into alcohol, and 3 days later, fingers crossed, you've got beer.
How much do you think the ale industry contributes to the region of Derby?
Massively. Derby is known as the capital of real ale in the country. It has more breweries per capita than anywhere else in the country. It has more different beers than anywhere else in the country per capita, although we tend to fight that one with Sheffield, so we'll win it 1 year, Sheffield wins it the other year. But yes, it is widely known as the capital of real ale in the country, and being as England is known as the capital of real ale in the world, therefore Derby by proxy is the capital of real ale in the entire world. So we do get a lot of real ale tourism coming to Derby, people coming here just for the real ale scene and that sort. The whole craft side of things, which has brought not only a lot of the younger generations in, but also a lot more females in, they're making a lot more female friendly, definitely trying to move away from the old school style of flat cap, whip it, pint of warm flat bitter, that sort of thing. Just purely little things that are very, very simple, like having branded glassware, having much more attractive glassware as well, things that will actually appeal to females. So yes, people have looked at that side of things, and obviously bringing a lot more people in. The only thing I say again going back is whether this is just a trend or not, or whether this is here to stay. Alcohol consumption is down, and has been down every year for the past 7, 8, 9 years, I believe. The only good thing, the silver lining, if you like, for this trade is that cask ale consumption as a percentage of whole alcohol consumption is going up, but across the board it is generally going down. If people deem these places to be too antiquated, then it might be difficult to actually change the whole ethos of the place and still keep it as it is. We're not quite sure, really, on that score. We're going to have to sort of keep our eye on the ball, ear to the ground, and play it by ear, as they say.